knows a lot about all kinds of stuff. Professor Dave Explains.
We've been studying linear second-order DEs with constant coefficients, and now it's time to look at some second-order DEs that are a bit more advanced. If instead of having constants multiplied by each y term and its derivatives, we have powers of x whose order matches the order of the derivative, then we call this a Cauchy-Euler differential equation. Notice that the standard form requires we have a leading coefficient of 1 in front of the second derivative term. On the right side, we can have any function f of x, which will make this non-homogeneous in general. The trick to solving Cauchy-Euler DEs is to use the substitution u equals natural log of x. This time, we are changing the independent variable x to a new independent variable u, and the dependent variable will still be y. This time, it takes a little work to get the expressions for the derivatives in terms of u. To find dy dx, we use the chain rule to write dy dx as dy du times du dx, where we can find that du dx is the derivative of log of x, which is 1 over x. To find d squared y dx squared, we need to take our last result and rearrange it to get dy du equals x dy dx, and then differentiate both sides. On the left, we can use the chain rule, and on the right, we can use the product rule. Then sub in the known expressions for du dx and dy dx. And finally, equating both sides leads to the second derivative we need. We then substitute these into our differential equation. And what will happen is that we will end up with a linear second-order differential equation with constant coefficients, which we already know how to solve from the previous tutorial. The right side of the DE will go from f of x to f of e to the u, and so our particular integral will usually contain exponential functions. Once we've got our general solution for y in terms of u, replacing u with natural log of x will lead to our final answer. We will find that the complementary solution often contains terms of the form x to the lambda, where lambda is a root of the transformed characteristic equation, because the usual form of e to the lambda u, once unsubstituted for u, results in the exponential and the logarithm canceling out. Let's see an example. Suppose we want to solve the DE 2x squared times d squared y dx squared plus 10x times dy dx minus 24y equals x cubed. We can see that this is a Cauchy-Euler DE, but to get it into our standard form, we first need to divide both sides by 2 so that the leading term has 1x squared. Now we have a standard Cauchy-Euler DE with coefficients b equals 5, c equals negative 12, and f of x equals 1/2 x cubed. By using the substitution x equals e to the u, we know that our DE will transform into a new DE, the second derivative of y with respect to u, plus 4dy du minus 12y equals 1/2 times e to the u cubed, where we have subtracted 1 from b and inserted e to the u into f of x on the right side. This is a second-order DE with constant coefficients, so we will write down the characteristic equation and solve it to find two distinct real roots, lambda equals 2 and lambda equals negative 6. So our complementary solution as a function of u will be this exponential form here. Now we just need the particular integral, which we can get from the method of undetermined coefficients using y equals ce to the 3u as the trial function. Differentiating and substituting into the DE, we find c equals 1 over 18. So the particular integral is 1/18 e to the 3u. The general solution is then y of u equals a e to the 2u plus b e to the negative 6u plus 1/18 e to the 3u. The last thing to do is undo our substitution, x equals e to the u, which we can rearrange to give u equals natural log of x. When we put u equals log of x into our solution y of u, we can use the laws of logarithms in the exponents, and we find that here the exponential terms will cancel with the logs, giving the general solution to our dE as y of x equals ax squared plus bx to the negative 6 plus 1/18 x cubed. The Cauchy-Euler equation is just one example of a type of dE that can be solved with substitutions, but it is important to remember that using substitutions is a general technique that can be applied to unfamiliar dEs. In fact, for nonlinear second-order dEs, it is often the only hope we have of finding a closed-form solution to them, if one exists at all. If we have a nonlinear dE that doesn't contain any y terms, such as d squared y dx squared plus dy dx squared equals 1, then we can use the substitution u equals dy dx to directly reduce the order of the dE by 1. Since the original dE was second order, the new dE in u will be first order, and while it is still nonlinear, we have a better shot of solving first order dEs using the methods we've learned before than second order. If we can find u, we can undo our substitution by integrating u with respect to x to find y. Outside of this, there are very few hard rules as to which substitutions will work to solve nonlinear DEs. If you're learning differential equations in a class, unless your professor is really mean, you won't be expected to know every last one of these more advanced cases, but you certainly should know how to use a given substitution in order to solve a nonlinear differential equation. In fact, mathematicians over the years have made careers out of identifying specific types of these differential equations, usually with some important application in physics or engineering. Let's take a look at some that they've come up with. Bessel's equation is a linear second-order differential equation with variable coefficients of the form x squared y double prime plus xy prime plus y times x squared minus n squared equals 0. Which kind of looks like a Cauchy-Euler equation, but with that factor x squared minus n squared on the y term. The Bessel equation arises when describing the vibrations of a circular membrane, which you can think of as modeling the sound waves produced when banging a drum. The two linearly independent solutions to Bessel's equation are called j sub n and y sub n, which are known as Bessel functions of order n. As you can imagine, Bessel's equation and others like it are used extensively in acoustics, which is the study of sound, but it also appears when describing constrained electromagnetic waves, which we will encounter in the upcoming electrical engineering series. There are countless more examples of differential equations where solutions are only available in terms of these so-called special functions, which are functions that are often specifically defined as being the solution to these problems. Two others that you might encounter are the Laguerre differential equation and the Legendre differential equation, which appear as part of the quantum mechanical wave function of the electron in a hydrogen atom, which is a notion that underpins all of physical chemistry. It's easy to see why people spend years studying these things, but we still have other things to get through, so have a go at some comprehension questions before moving on.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.